You were in the ring Saturday night after Ryan Garcia's knockout win. It looked good. That knockout was phenomenal. That left hook. What went on in the ring after the fight? It was your son, Devin Haney, yourself, Ryan, well, and I think Oscar.
That was a phenomenal knockout on a little guy. You know what I mean? Like, everybody, I'm saying, there we go, not telling the truth. Fonseca fought Tank at 130 pounds. You know, nothing about Ryan Garcia or Devin Haney is 130 pounds. We don't have a, you know, Fonseca can go back down to 130. He came up from 130. So for all intent purposes, on the stage that it was, in front of the people that it was, it was against a littler guy, a smaller guy.
But 5 pounds is not much of a difference. It's not like he brought up from 22, 26.
It was against a smaller guy. It was against a smaller guy that, you know, had already lost. You know, who had already got accustomed to losing.
But he and Ryan weighed the same at the weigh-in, 134.8. So it's not like he came in much smaller. But
at the weigh-in or after they hydrated back up?
That I don't know. I didn't check them after they hydrated. But Ryan looked good.
Well, yeah. No. I cannot say that Ryan wasn't impressive, you know. But, I mean, when analyzing the situation, I would think that, you know, we would tell the truth in our assessment of it. I think that we would tell the truth in our assessment of what kind of opponent he was. And I think that's why I was saying with Dev is he was trying to explain that to Bernard Hopkins is that the opponent was not a worthy opponent to gauge superstardom. If that's the case, if we're judging superstardom, then Zaur Abdalev, Antonio Moran, who had gave Pedraza, who had went the distance with Jose Pedraza, Zaur Abdalev, who had beat up Hank Lundy, you know, Juan Carlos Burgos, who had fought Mikey Garcia and hurt him in the fight.
Is very tall, too.
Burgos is very tall, you know what I mean? But I think that...
Who's the one guy from New Orleans that had knockout of the year? Do you guys fight him, too?
No, I'm not sure. I'm not sure about that. But also, we had the African kid that was 25-0 from, you know, from Africa. But he, when I say that to say that Fonseca, in Devin's eyes, was not saying that it's not a stepping stone or it's not a building fight or it's not a stay busy fight, but to say that it was another step, a stardom, you know what I mean? Now a star is born. Do you agree with that, Ellie? Do you think that was...
I was impressed by that punch because it's hard to knock out a person, period, and it's in minute 20 and a big punch. It was impressive to me.
I think, when you talk about the punch being impressive, it was, but I also saw when he hit him with a jab, he fell back. Like, I was like, Dev, I was like, this dude here is on shaky legs. You know what I mean? From the minute. Did you see that? Like, did you see from the very beginning he looked very shaky? You know, he didn't belong in there with Ryan. Ryan's a stud. He's 135-pound stud. Devin's 130. They don't, you know. When you talk about Gary Russell, now you talk about a different animal.